Hi, Bruce from Safiery, and this is part two on our new Meteor battery. And in this video, we're actually going to run both the 12 volt and the 48 volt loads off this single battery train. And so what I've got my hands on here is our new Meteor battery. This happens to be a 48 volt, could also be 36 or 24 volt. And the battery plugs together, and they can be up to 5 long, and then in parallel, up to 16 altogether. And 200 amp hour at 12 volts. So this battery's got a positive plug on one end, and it's got a 12 volt and a 48 volt power lead coming out of it. If I plug it in there now, then all I'll get out of it is 48 volt. And so that's where our Scotty Meteor comes in. And here it is here in my hand. That's the equivalent to our Scotty 1500 inside this case here, but it's all pre-plugged, pre-wired, set to go as a true plug and play. Let's see how good it is. And that's it, plugged in. And now we put the plug onto the front, and now we are ready to go. So let's turn on the 48 volt side first. So now I've got the induction running there at 2000 watts. Now let's turn on the 12 volt side, and we've chosen a 48 watt steady lamp here. And let's plug that in. And it's now connected on the 12 volt side. Now the big advantage with Scotty AI is the smartphone app. Here's the smartphone app. It says everything's running, status is good, no errors. And I'm gonna go down now to the can battery here. And on the can battery here, it's giving me all the values out of the battery, state of charge, state of health, charge current, discharge current limit, voltage, of course. It's giving me all the data coming out of the 48 volt battery. So the 48 volt battery is going through Scotty, which is a DC to DC, in this case, 48 to 12 volts, and is delivering 12 volts out to run the lights. So if this is in a caravan, you don't need a 12 volt battery system, you just need the 48 volt and Scotty, and you can deliver up to 1500 watts, which is enough to drive air suspension in the caravan quite comfortably, and there's no need for any other 12 volt power source. Now of course, then once we start charging, which we're going to do in a minute, then it'll work back the other way. What will happen then is when the Anderson plug is hooked in, 12 volts coming in, and the 12 volt will in fact not only run the 12 volt system, but it will also charge the 48 volt battery, because Scotty is a bi-directional DC to DC. So now I'm simulating charging the 48 volt through, say, an Anderson plug or directly off the alternator, or if you're in a motorhome or a van. And I've got about 80 amps on there, close to 1000 watts. I'm also running light here, so the 12 volt in the van's continuing to run while you're doing all this, but we're now charging the 48 volt side. So if we have a look at the app here at the moment, it's being charged at around 15 amps at 53 volts at the moment, and the state of charge of the battery is at 86%, state of health is 100%, and it shows you the charge current limit and the discharge current limit. Now, for people interested in batteries, the can battery is telling the charging devices exactly how much to charge. And that's based on the temperature of the battery and the state of charge of the battery and the overall absolute voltage. Now, if you have a Victron system, Victron listens to that and sets the solar charger, the AC charger, and of course in Scotty, we're setting the Scotty charger, so that all the devices march to the same tune as set by the battery. If you have a battery that doesn't have a CAN BMS, then the charge profile in all of those devices has to be exactly the same. And because of cable length and resistance and drop-off, my experience is they're never all exactly the same. And there's a risk that you can overcharge the lithium battery and have potentially a thermal runaway. I've seen it happen when the charge voltages are not set correctly and the battery is not sitting on the can. So the can bus coming out of the battery, which we're reading here, in my opinion, is absolutely crucial to have in any lithium battery system of the future. And so one of the nice features on this battery, particularly if you've got a caravan and you put it into the shed for a period of time, is the ease of turning it on and off. And if I want to shut down this battery at the moment, I simply go to the app here and turn Scotty off. As you can see there now, it's off. And then to shut the battery down, I simply just hold this button for 3 seconds. And you can see the LED lights on the top come on one battery and the second. And these batteries are now totally off. How good's that?